Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from One Hive Gazette, here with the next video, and today's topic is miners. Miners are completely back. Town Hall 10, 11, 12, but especially Town Hall 11 and double especially Town Hall 12. They are kind of making their way to the meta very, very quickly. And I'm not sure exactly what it is in the recent updates, but there has been some adjustments to them, and they are a very viable option. Part of it's just the base building. Bases are more susceptible to it, and they will adjust, I think, to defend it. So this video, we're going to be talking about the keys to the miner attack strategy, looking at some good replays at Town Hall 10, 11, 12 as examples. Town Hall 12, first and foremost, as we look at this first replay here, it's all about, I guess, any town hall level. In general, for the miners, it's all about keeping them spread out while keeping them on defenses, not on trash buildings, storages, stuff on the outside. So it's a balance of keeping them spread out enough, but not too spread out. One of the things that makes them so powerful at Town Hall 12 is the Giga Tesla, or the Suicide Town Hall thing. When it explodes there, the miners duck down quick enough to avoid it. And that's something no other troop can do. Your balloons are going to get killed by it. Your hogs will, assuming there's no warden tome to protect them. And yes, I said tome, not tomb. Oh, I agree. It's okay. Let's move beyond that. My point is, this is one of the unique troops that you can get away with using the warden's ability elsewhere as needed. Assuming there's not like a weird skeleton spell that keeps them up, but I haven't really been seeing that happen, even if people do put skeleton spells by the town hall, because the miners tend to duck down anyway and avoid it. So like I said, you'll notice the key is keeping those miners spread out enough that they aren't just going defense to defense, and they have to go quick enough that they don't get targeted for that long. Because if they're going, you know, one, two defenses at a time, eventually the DPS will be too much. You can't keep them healed forever. It's a time issue. They're vulnerable. You got to get them to the base quickly. But at the same time, if they're too spread out, you can't have them wandering to the outside. You have to keep them funneled inside the base, taking out trash buildings. It's not as important as you might think as in terms of how many like storages are in the base, if you count them, because this base, there's, you know, several storages by that Inferno Tower. It obviously helps if it's more defenses inside the base, so your miners are almost exclusively targeting defenses. That's a good thing, but a few extra storages inside the base isn't going to be a huge problem as long as the miners are spread just the right amount. Also, the Wall Wrecker, you know, it doesn't matter if it opens up walls, but it does a nice job tanking. So you might as well use it if you can, if it's the right side of the base to use it on, and get some value there. So the Queen Walks are a very nice thing to do along with it. This was a weird one because the Queen actually came in with the miners. Oftentimes you'll see the Queen walk one side, the King clear out the other side, and the miners go through. Now this is a good base for it because it's kind of a natural funnel through the base. The queen takes off the top part, and then there's a very nice split. So miners taking out this area, miners up for the Inferno Tower, the queen helping as well. Actually, not really any miners up there, I guess. Mainly just the queen, but that's fine. The push is good with the Wall Wrecker, and loses quite a few to spring traps, but has the warden's ability. Doesn't get great value from that either, actually. But it goes to show the power of this strategy if it's able to crush the base, even with a few hiccups. By the way, the P.E.K.K.A. is a nice touch along the outside. Some people use it too much, and I won't say who, but they know who they are. But in general, the P.E.K.K.A. is a nice touch because it'll take out defenses, it'll tank. It has both the damage and the hit points. So if there's a lot of defenses on the outside, in addition to your king, you might want to consider a P.E.K.K.A. for certain areas of the base, to kind of help clear out and keep the miners inside the base, because that is very important, keeping them spread out, but also inside the base, taking out defenses. They're not helping you if they're on the outside targeting gold mines and stuff like that. Let's move on to a couple Town Hall 11 ones, and it's pretty similar. Once again, Queen Walks are nice, because the way the bases are built at Town Hall 11 and Town Hall 12, this one maybe not as much so as others, but they tend to be a little bit more spread out because of the warden's ability getting so much value if it's too compact. So this allows for a lot of these queen walks along the side of the base without having to really spend much, and you can get great value. So that's why you see the queen walks with the miners, especially at Town Hall 11 and Town Hall 12. This one, the queen took on a lot of damage right away, and I think she will go down because the healers switch. But the important thing is that the miners are going through. They're relatively spread out. Now, things that can ruin the miners is if they get aggroed by the queen all at once, or like they all bunch up on like a scaly trap or the king. You'd be surprised how that can just destroy an attack if they all get into one big group and never leave that group. So it's important to, even if you think you're spreading them out at the beginning, they can easily group up if you don't have like very solid deployment in mind. It's not just like a three-finger drop. You got to consider where there's more DPS or more hit points, how long it's going to take to get through that section, and you got to deploy them evenly enough so they go through as in one wave. If one side's too quick, it might get targeted, and your miners might all fall into one group. That's what you want to avoid as much as possible. Don't be afraid to heal multiple groups at once because you want them to be spread out. That's one of the keys of this attack strategy that we're going to be talking about. So anyway, the healers switch onto the miners, which is kind of a nice touch. And you can see how many are left up at the end of this attack. Crush the base. Seems like it's very rare that this, like, barely 3 stars. It seems like it either kind of flops completely or it crushes the base. It's kind of a weird attack strategy. Whereas, like, the witch bowler, so often it's just like there's that one witch left up at the end and it's always so close. So it's kind of weird how this one differs in that regard. One more Town Hall 11 one. Once again, has 5 healers for the queen, and this is a little bit of a lower, like a tier 1, I guess, Town Hall 11, but it has the eagle, has a few defenses upgraded, I think. Maybe not. But this definitely would have worked, I think, against a base of max level. So drops down heroes on both sides. Like I said, the wall wrecker, might as well use it, tank a little bit, then you can have some miners come out of it, or hogs. Hogs coming out of the wall wrecker is not bad either. I'm kind of a fan of that as well, and I think this attack, there's hogs in it, so you guys will see what I mean in just a moment. But like I said, queen can get some great value on these bases. They're a little bit more spread out. So she's doing her thing up top. The king with the ability. Always a few wizards is a good touch to use on the king to back him up and keep him moving through. And then hogs come out, and you can see there is a rage as well. And those hogs just tear through some of these defenses, and they get the value of the rages and the heals. So, I mean, there's already enough miners. Might as well bring some hogs to get on those defenses even quicker than the miners might otherwise do. So it's a nice touch if you have a lot of miners. And there's going to be like a big group of defenses like the Eagle, Inferno Towers, stuff like that. And you can get the Rage and the Heal on those Hogs. They'll do some work for you. So crushed this base. We'll move on to some Town Hall 10s. You guys might be wondering, you know, defensive Clan Castle, where's this all stand? Because it's tricky. At Town Hall 12, you sometimes have the Baby Dragon Hound, which can be poisoned, but at the same time, it's a little bit sketchy sometimes trying to kill the baby dragon with just one poison. So that's kind of a risk you might have to take if there are some CC troops like that. Now, one thing you can do is bring a little surprise in your wall wrecker. Let me find the right base here before we move on with that point. 28, I think. Yeah, 28. So you can sometimes bring a Valk if it's a tough ground CC or something. You can bring, I've seen people bring a baby dragon as part of the CC. There might be some air traps, but maybe not if you're not by air defenses or anything. And the baby dragon hops out. It gets the rage effect because it's the only air troop in the area. And then you can take out, you know, a baby dragon, if a witch, if needed, with that baby dragon in your CC. I guess the main thing you have to worry about is maybe a bunch of Valks or a baby dragon or like a big dragon. Those are probably the main concerns that might take out your miners, the air troops and the Valks with their DPS. So it helps to maybe bring something in the wall wrecker if you know it can get far enough and kind of be there when the CC troops are attacking the miners. Sorry about the notifications. Is that one stuck? Okay. I should have put the Do Not Disturb on, but a little bit of a throwback to me forgetting to put on Do Not Disturb. Anyway, at Town Hall 10, we don't see the Queen Walks as much. Town Hall 10 bases tend to be a little more compact in general, a little more anti-Queen Walk. Typically not as much value. You kind of want to go mass miner, although we will look at an example that does have a Queen Walk, talk about why. But oftentimes it's these kind of square-ish bases. Now, don't be confused that you don't always want to do it on a square base. It's not the walls that necessarily matter as much. It's what you can clear out with your queen and your king. Can you leave a nice spread for your miners? But is it also easy to keep the trash separated from the defenses inside the base? In this case, the king and the queen were both able to create a great funnel on either side, but sometimes there's going to be trash that your king can't reach on one side, your queen can't reach on one side, the base might be funky, there might be like a weird like little inlet where the miners might get drawn out or something. So you just gotta always be careful about what bases you hit with this strategy. Last attack here is one of theirs. I wanted to show it because it was a nice Town Hall 10 Queen Charge Miner attack. And I do mean Queen Charge, not just a Queen Walk. She's going to go straight towards the defensive King there. And this base, a little bit more spread out, a little bit more Town Hall 11, 12-ish, in that it has those like separate compartments that aren't like connected by walls. Which makes it easier to do a queen charge on, and the miners will work just fine as well. So queen's going to come in, get some good value. We'll fast forward just a little bit here as she goes through this walk. And then the king, I believe, is used up at 12 o'clock there. Nice wizard on the king as well. She will have to deal with the hound CC. So keep in mind, if it was just using the heroes, could have just poisoned the loon and not had to deal with the hound, but then there'd be too much base left up. It'd be too spread out. The miners would be too thin. It needs to be a little bit more compact. Maybe the width of like two heal spells is an ideal spread for your miners to have to deal with. So the king comes in. He can clear out this entire row. Queen gets that wizard tower. So basically what's being left is just this, we got 1, 2, 3, a little bit of a gap, and like 4-ish rows of defenses, or columns of defenses, I guess. And, oops, kind of fast-forwarded there. Freeze on the queen as well, which was interesting, maybe to not make the miners aggro as much. I think there was a hog or two in the CC, which I like, and the healers switch nicely onto the miners. That's one of the benefits, is unless there's like an air defense bearing down on your queen, even if she dies, she can, the healers can switch onto the miners, which is a nice touch. So that's kind of some insurance on the queen walk there. But yeah, crush this base. Guys, the miners are very powerful at Town Hall 10, 11, and 12, but especially those top Town Hall levels. So look to use them. I know this wasn't the most in-depth guide on what bases, what deployment. I'm still figuring them out to some extent too, but I hope I can share some ideas with you guys and get you thinking about how to use these miners. Until next time, thanks for watching as we fast forward to the end here. See you guys later. Bisectatron out.